I'm Phil Pratt. I'm the organist here at Christ Episcopal Church in Charlevoix, Michigan, and I'd like to welcome you to the 2023 online organ concert, which is actually the fourth in our annual series of online organ concerts. We're going to begin this concert with a movement from a tone poem of Richard Strauss called Also Sprach Zarathustra. Thus spake Zarathustra, an ancient Persian prophet. You're probably familiar with this movement because it was used as the opening music from the movie 2001, A Space Odyssey. Here it is. Years ago, my father-in-law went on an honor flight where they fly World War II veterans to Washington, D.C. for the day to be honored in all sorts of ways. My wife went with him as his guardian. My role was to meet them when they returned to the St. Pete Clearwater Airport that evening. And there was a huge crowd. I know there's always a good crowd when an honor flight returns, but this was especially big, I think, in part because of the day it occurred. It was the day after the Boston bombing, and the airport terminal was absolutely packed. So when the veterans came in from the plane, they were greeted by a huge crowd, cheering them, welcoming them home, and thanking them for their service. And all throughout the crowd, people were waving American flags and shouting, USA, USA. The whole experience made me think of two patriotic songs, When Johnny Comes Marching Home Again and Rally Round the Flag, which is also called the Battle Cry of Freedom. I decided I wanted to compose a piece for organ based on those two patriotic songs. Because they both came from the Civil War, I called the result Civil War Medley. Here it is. Thank you. next piece is The Swan by Camille Saint-Saëns. It's one movement in a piece that he wrote called The Carnival of the Animals. When I hear this, I picture a lake with perfectly calm water. It's like a mirror, and there's a single swan where we see the swan and its reflection slowly gliding across the surface of the lake. Here is The Swan by Camille Saint-Saëns. Next, we have a movement from the Gothic suite of Leon Boelmann. This movement is called Chorale, and to me, it makes me think of some huge, magnificent European cathedral with big stone walls, just as impressive as can be. So here is the Chorale from the Gothic suite of Leon Boelmann.
Thank you.
Next, we're going to have another movement from the Gothic suite of Boelmann. But where the last one was big and powerful, this one is more meditative and contemplative. Here is the Prière à Notre Dame, or Prayer to Our Lady, from the Gothic suite of Leon Boelmann. I'm sure many of you are familiar with the piece called Sing We Now of Christmas. Here is Gordon Young's arrangement of Sing We Now of Christmas.
Thank you.
concert a couple years ago, I told you about Scott Joplin, who composed from the late 1800s through the early 1900s. He was the most prolific composer of a style of music called ragtime, where individual pieces were called rags. Now, a rag is a lot like a march. The only difference is rags made heavy use of what's called syncopation. Now, normally, important notes are on the beat. Da, 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 da. With syncopation, some of the important notes are off the beat. Da, 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 da. Unfortunately for ragtime, in the early to mid 1900s, there were people who felt that syncopation was evil. And consequently, ragtime didn't really achieve the popularity we would have expected. That popularity didn't come along until the 1970s, when a terrific, well-loved, award-winning movie came out called The Sting. All of the music in The Sting consisted of rags. And people loved the movie, they loved the music, and all of a sudden ragtime was popular, as it should have been all along. Now, at that concert 2 years ago, I did what many people consider to be the original rag. Scott Joplin composed it at a period in his life when he was performing at a club in Sedalia, Missouri called the Maple Leaf Club, and he called the piece the Maple Leaf Rag. This year, I'm going to do what many people consider to be the best known of all the rags, because it was the featured rag in the Sting. It is called The Entertainer, and again, it's by Scott Joplin. Here it is. Last year, I told you how some organs have what is referred to as a solo trumpet stop, a stop that produces a trumpet-like sound that's big enough and powerful enough to hold its own against whatever else is going on in the organ. There are different types of solo trumpet stops. Some pipe organs, for example, have what's called a trumpet enchaînement, where the pipes are horizontal, sticking straight out from the wall in the shape of a fan. Other organs have a festival trumpet as a solo trumpet stop. Still others, like this one, have a fanfare trumpet. And now featuring that fanfare trumpet, here is the trumpet prelude of Johann Roman. A prelude is typically a short piece of music that's often intended to introduce something else. But there are some preludes that stand on their own, like the last one, the trumpet prelude that we just heard. Another one that could be part of a bigger piece, but it also can stand alone, is the prelude in C major by Johann Sebastian Bach. Thank you. An elegy is a poem or a piece of music of serious reflection, often a lament for the dead. There are many beautiful elegies. To me, this next one by George Thorben Ball is one of the most beautiful. So here is George Thorben Ball's elegy. One of my favorite hymns from when I was growing up was Onward Christian Soldiers. So I recently heard an arrangement of it by an absolutely outstanding organist named Gert Van Heff. When I heard it, I thought, I just need to do that on a concert sometime. So here is Gert Van Heff's arrangement of Onward Christian Soldiers. Thank you. I've done this next piece, Highland Cathedral, on previous concerts, but I like it so well I decided to do it again. When my wife and I were visiting Scotland, we got to hear this piece played on the bagpipes on three separate occasions. On two of those occasions, I had a chance to talk to the bagpiper after he was done, and I asked both of them what pieces were most often requested, and they both said the same thing. The two pieces that they were most often requested to play on the bagpipes are Amazing Grace and Highland Cathedral. Now, I do not play the bagpipes, so instead I will be doing Highland Cathedral on the organ. Here is Highland Cathedral by Ulrich Roper and Michael Korb, as arranged for organ by Charles Callahan.
Thank you.
Louis Vierne was an outstanding organist. He was the organist at Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris from 1900 until his death in 1937. He was also a prolific composer of music for the organ, including 6 organ symphonies. Here is the finale from his first organ symphony.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching and for listening. I hope you enjoyed the concert, and I wish you the best. Goodbye.